Roof, rough, rough. It doesn't matter what you call it, it is an important part of your house. It's a design element when you first pull up in front of a home. Plus, it's also a structural element. Without the roof, the walls will not stand up. Your house isn't designed that way. It's got to have a roof on top of it. And it's also the weatherproofing element on your house. It keeps out all that rain, hail, and snow, so it's very, very important. Now, as far as design and how you build the house, a lot depends on the actual pitch that you pick for your roof. Pitch comes from flat, which is called a 0-12 pitch, to fairly steep, which would be a 12-12 pitch. How do you come up with those numbers? 12-12, 0-12, 6-12, 10-12? It's how much pitch angle is on your roof. When you have a flat roof, if you measure 12 inches across, it moves up and down 0. When you have a 6-12 pitch, if you'd measure 12 inches across on your roof, it would fall 6 inches. When you have a 12-12 pitch, you measure 12 inches across your roof, it comes down 12 inches before you hit the roof again. That'd be a 45 degree angle. Now occasionally you even see them steeper than that, but normally most roofs nowadays goes from 6-12 to about 10-12, running that angle. Now the steep pitch is great if you live in an area where there's a lot of ice and snow because it doesn't build up as much on your roof, it just slides right off. The 6-12 pitch, what's great about that, it's less expensive because the less pitch, the less area that you actually have to shingle. The more pitch you have, the more lumber you're actually going to have to build your roof with, so a lot more shingles. Now the flat roofs, people use them sometimes where there's areas where there's very moderate rainfall and where there's very, very moderate snowfall, maybe in Arizona or Southern California. But as far as most homeowners, you're going to be somewhere between a 6-12, 8-12, and a 10-12. When it comes to the design or the look of your roof, boy, there's a lot of choices there. Like here we have a gable projecting out for some bedrooms on the front of this house. It adds a lot of variety to the roof line, so it's really pleasant to the eyes when you first pull up. But like I said, the choices are endless. Let's take a walk around the neighborhood and look at some of the variety. Now I mentioned a gabled roof. That's a roof where two sides slope towards one another over a vertical wall. The two sloping sides come together to form a ridge. A ridge is the highest horizontal point on a roof. The inside angle formed by the two sections of a roof is called a valley. On this type of roof, all sides of the roof slope towards the ridge, so there are no vertical surfaces on the roof. This is called a hip roof. The outside angle formed by two sloping sides of the roof is called the hip. Roofs nowadays come in all shapes and designs, and it's pretty common to find a combination of design elements in a single roof, so you can let your imagination run free when it comes to the design of a roof on a new home. Well, your design choices for a roof are limitless, but always remember, the steeper the roof is, the longer it's going to last in bad weather. The snow and the water will fall off of it and your shingles will have a longer life. But it's also going to take a lot more shingles and a lot more material to build that roof because the steeper it is, the more area you have to cover. If you'd like more information about picking out the right roof for your house, contact us on the internet at michaelholligan.com.